Heather here today with Frazier 5 in 5, and I'm going to try to tell you as much about 5 things as I can in about 1 minute each. So, a picture is worth 1,000 words, the average novel is about 75,000 words, and I get about 120 words to tell you about some of my favorite Kentucky writers. He's a native of Danville. He graduated from Spalding University's MFA program, and he's best known for his work founding the Afro-Latia movement, which calls attention to the diversity of Appalachia. So there's a literary connection to Lewis and Clark, which is why I'm starting here. Walker's book, Buffalo Dance, explores the untold story of York, who's right behind me. So he was the enslaved person who was integral to the Lewis and Clark journey and the expedition across the United States. So several of Walker's books take that idea of hidden figures in history and expand on these characters that he finds. And he actually revisited York's life with a book called When Winter Come, The Ascension of York. So Walker is an active poet and educator, and one of his poems, Seed Time in the Commonwealth, was written to commemorate U of K's 150th anniversary. So that's the University of Kentucky, and they engraved that poem on the wall of the Student Center. In light of coronavirus, Walker wrote a poem called Mama Sorry School, which we'll actually link to in the comments. With the centennial of the 19th Amendment this year, the first wave of women's fight for equality and early feminism has been on people's minds. So as many people know, we're now on the third wave, and a Kentucky author, Bell Hooks, was integral in shaping that. So Bell Hooks was born Gloria Jean Watkins. Bell Hooks is a pen name that is never capitalized that she adopted after her grandmother. She was born in Hopkinsville, and she was educated all over the U.S., and she got her doctorate at Stanford. She wrote her dissertation on Toni Morrison. Her works of cultural critique and poetry are known all over the world, and they explore the intersection of people's identities along the lines of gender, as well as race, economic status, and so on. So her first major work harkens back to Sojourner Truth, who is right behind me. So its title is Ain't I a Woman? And it's a reference to Truth's speech, I am a woman's right, which went down in history when it was mistranslated in incorrect dialect to make it Ain't I a Woman, which is supposed to sound more folksy. Bell Hooks is now a professor at Berea, the first non-segregated college to be built in Kentucky. So she founded the Bell Hooks Institute there in 2014. All right, I'm standing in front of a dress that belongs to another Kentucky author whose book told a story that people were already familiar with. So Loretta Lynn's memoir, Coal Miner's Daughter, was written with the help of George Vexey, and it tells the story behind her breakout hit of the same name. The book was written in 1976, about 6 years after her song peaked on the charts, and it was popular enough to inspire an Oscar-winning film of the same name, starring Sissy Spacek, who actually followed Loretta Lynn for a period of time to pick up on her accent. So Spacek originally didn't want to do the project, so she insisted on doing her own singing. She was hoping it would scare the producers off. But not only does she star in this movie, but she does all of her own singing, and she reads the audiobook as well, which makes it a really, really fun experience. When I was a kid, I remember going to the grocery store with my mom and seeing the mass market paperbacks. A is for Alibi, E is for Evidence, and so on, and they really felt like a fixture of my childhood. And I'm sure they were for kids across the country riding around in shopping carts, because author Sue Grafton's Kinsey Malone Alphabet series topped the New York Times bestseller list for a total of about 400 weeks. So that is 8 years, give or take. So no wonder you could buy them everywhere, including Kroger. And guess what? Sue Grafton was born right here in Louisville in 1940 and graduated from Atherton High School. She attended Western Kentucky University for 2 years and then moved on to writing screenplays. She was intrigued by the book series that had interrelating titles, and she was actually really inspired by Edward Gorey's Ghastly Crumb Tinies, so she decided her approach for these interrelated titles would be the alphabet. So sadly, Grafton died in 2017, and the Kinsey Malone series ended at the letter Y. Her family is honoring her wishes to not employ a ghostwriter, so according to them, that is the end of the alphabet as far as they're concerned. So speaking of grocery stores, if you've ever wowed people with your secret family recipe that actually comes from a box, and just let the record show that I did not do that and ruin the holiday bake-off, person you're going to find out about next is another Kentucky writer, and you owe this to Duncan Hines. Duncan Hines was born in 1880 in Bowling Green, Kentucky. He was a traveling salesman who spent a lot of time on the road, and he figured he knew a lot about restaurants. And so that turned into a million-dollar idea, his first book, Adventures in Good Eating. This book was, in a way, kind of the first travel blog. It was cataloging the places Hines had enjoyed in his travels. The book quickly morphed into a lifestyle brand, and Hines became the prototype for people like Martha Stewart and Rachel Ray and later influencers, complete with Duncan Hines' dining car experiences on the Louisville and Nashville Railroad, and really cute mid-century modern dishware. So Hines wrote many other books over the next three decades, and his legacy lives on in those delicious dessert mixes and the writing format he pioneered. Phew, so there we go. 5 authors in 5 minutes. And I had a great time. I hope you did too. And until I can see you in real life, I will see you virtually.